Assalamu alaikum students. Today I am going to talk about radical expressions with the help of example. Example is there in front of you all. We will see how to multiply and divide radical expressions. So here there are two methods. The first one is we will multiply root 8 and root 12. As there is no sign in between, so we will multiply. It means multiplication. Multiplying 8 by 12, we got 96. Now, factorizing this 96 in such a way that we would get such a factor which can be written outside the radical sign means its square root could be found. So it can be written as 16 multiplied by root 6. This root 16 can be written as 4 and root 6 as it is. This is our answer. This is the first method to multiply root 8 and root 12. Now let's see the second method. Here again root 8 can be written as root 4 and root 2. Root 12 can be written as root 4 and root 3. Let's find out the square root of root 4, that is 2. Root 2 as it is multiplied by again root 4 can be written as 2 and root 3. Final answer. 2 multiplied by 2 outside the radical sign, that is 4, root 6, same as before. So these were the two methods to find out the product of root 8 and root 12. Okay, let's see the next example. 3 root 75 multiplied by 4 root 128. How we will solve this? Let's see. 3 as it is, 75 can be factorized as root 25 and root 3. Next, 4 under root 64 and under root 2. 128 can be written as root 64 and root 2. What is the square root of 64? That is 8. Square root of 25 is 5. So 3 as it is, 5 is the square root, and root 3 as it is. Here 4 as it is, square root of 64 is 8, root 2 as it is. Multiplying the numbers written outside the radical sign. So 15 we got, and then next is root 3 as it is. Here 4 multiplied by 8 is 32 and root 2 as it is. What we are going to do now, this the numbers written within the radical sign is root 3 and root 2. These are the two numbers we are going to multiply these two. So we got root 6. Multiplying 15 by 32, what we will get? It will be 480. So, see here, we got 480 root 6. This is our answer. Okay, now the next example, 40x² / q. Now we have got some variables also. This is the difference in this example and the previous ones. The next radical, 98x^5 and y. Okay, what we are going to do is again factorizing the numbers. 40 can be written as root 4 and root 10. Now 98, root 98 can be written as root 49 and root 2. Now we are left with the variables, that is x² in the first radical sign, under the first radical sign, and then x^5 in the second one. Bases are same, we will add them. We got x^7. Next is by 6. Now, this is x7 and y6, which we have got with square root sign. Now, in the next step, what we are going to do is find the square root of this 4, we got 2. Square root of 49, we got 7. Now, we are left with root 10 and root 2. You know that root 10 means 5 multiplied by 2. So 5 will remain here inside the radical sign, and 2 from here and 2 from here will be paired up, and you will get root 4, and then outside the radical sign we will write in the next step 2. Okay, let's see the next step. Here, this is square root of x7 and y6. x7, how can we find out the square root? Again, see here, this can be written as x6 and x1. Square root of x6 is x3. x1 will remain inside the radical sign. On the other hand, square root of y6 is y3, and we are left with no y variable written inside the radical. I told you earlier, this 4 can be written, square root 4 can be written as 2. So the numbers outside the radical sign are 2, 7 and 2. It's 5 inside the radical sign. So we multiply all these numbers, and this 5 will come with this x. See here, multiplying these three numbers, we got 28 x3 y3 outside the radical sign, and root 5 and x inside the radical sign. You know that we do not write x raised to the power 1, so we will write only 5x inside the radical. Now, the next example. This is dividing radical expressions. So, under root 64 upon 81, simply find out the square root. We got 8 upon 9. Next example. 125 upon 72. Now we are going to factorize this root 125 and root 72. We have written these two in separate radical signs. Now 125 can be factorized as root 25 and root 5. Under root 72 can be written as root 36 and root 2. Now you can see we can find out the square root of 25, that is 5. We can find out the square root of 36 as 6. And this is our final answer. 5 root 5 upon 6 root 2. This cannot be simplified further. But one thing we can do, rationalizing the denominator, we can multiply and divide it by again root 2. And we got rid of radical sign in the denominator. Let's see. This 5, root 5 multiplied by root 2. So this root 5 and root 2 got 10. This root 2 and root 2 we got under root 4. Square root of root 10 cannot be found. So we will write it again in the numerator as it is, and what we will be left with in the denominator will be 6, and square root of 4 is 2. So we got 5 root 10 in the numerator and 12 in the denominator. Next example. Again, with some variables, and this is dividing radical expressions. x^16, x^5, y^7, z^3, r^4. Denominator 27, x^2, y^5, z^9, r^14. Let's see how we are going to solve it. This can be written as 4, that is square root of 16. And in a denominator, 27 can be written as root 9 and root 3 with multiplication sign in between. Now come to the variable x^5 and x^2. See here, how can we solve it? Same bases are there, so we will subtract the powers. Okay, I was telling you that we are going to subtract these powers. We got 3. So here you can see that we got x^3, and here 7 - 5 = 2, 5^2. Inside the radical sign, we are getting all this. In the denominator, √9 = 3. Now find out the square root of this 6. z^6. We got z^3. r^10. Square root of it is r^5. And this 3 will remain here. In the numerator, this 4 is outside. x^3. How we are going to solve x^3? x^3 will become x^2 multiplied by x. And the square root of x^2 is x, which is written outside. And 1x will remain inside the radical sign. So this way we are going to solve the numerator. This y, it is square. So when we are going to find out the square root of this y², we will get y outside. So 1x outside, 1y outside, and inside the radical sign we will be left with x and root 3 as it is. See what we are going to do in the next step. We can write the radical signs together. 4xy outside the radical sign, inside the radical sign we have written 3x. A denominator, we can write 9 outside, then z^3 and r^5 outside the radical sign. What we are left with? We will be left with nothing inside the radical sign in the denominator. So this is our final answer. Hope you would have understood this example as well. Thank you.